Boba. What's up, guys? I hope you're safe and healthy and happy and doing okay. I'm currently riding the Peloton, as you might be able to tell, because I did a 10-mile run yesterday, and today is supposed to be taking it easy, so I'm just doing like a 20-minute ride to flush the legs out. I'm trying the scenic rides, which I've never done before. I'm in Oregon, apparently. But the main reason for today's video is cold weather is approaching. Winter is coming for all of my Game of Thrones fans out there. And we need to talk about what we're gonna be wearing on our bodies to keep ourselves warm during these winter months. So I'm gonna finish up here, and then we're gonna talk all about my essentials when it comes to running in the cold weather. Ruby hates when I'm on the Peloton. What are you doing, Rube? Licking the sweat off of my body? Oh, thank you. There's really not much there. You're in the way of the shot. All right, so like I said before, we're gonna talk all about winter running essentials, what I wear on my runs in the winter and the colder months to stay warm but not overheat. Summer's over, but we just have to accept that we gotta get our pumpkin spice lattes and our hot cocoa and our warm cozy blankets ready, and also our warm running attire. So let's get started. So I figured I'd give you guys a rundown from what I'm wearing on my head all the way down to my feet. Let's start with the noggin. So for days that it's really not that cold, but I do want something to protect my ears, maybe it's a bit windy, I'll wear a headband like this. This is an Under Armour brand, but lots of other brands make headbands like this. This is pretty thin, but it's lined, so it keeps you warm, and it just covers your ears. Now the cool thing about this headband that I've done before is I pair it with a hat. Here's just my standard Hoka hat that I always wear. And this way I'm getting some top of the head protection, but I'm also getting some ear protection here as well. And this was one of my go-tos this past winter. I love this combination. But of course, some days it is blistering cold outside, and I'll have a standard beanie with me. This is just a Philadelphia Marathon beanie that I got when I did it in 2018. But really, any beanie will do. You could probably also pair it with the headband, although I don't think I've ever done that, just for some extra ear protection. The next area of the body I'm gonna talk about is the neck, because that can get super cold, especially on really windy days. So the first thing that I have here is the Tracksmith neck warmer. I really like this. I found it super helpful on like 20 degree days. I'll demo it for you. Now my hair is gonna be a mess by the end of this. Not that it already wasn't a mess. It just keeps you warm. And another great thing about it is that depending on how cold it is outside, sometimes your face needs protection as well. So you just flip this right up like this. And there you go. Your nose and your mouth are covered. And because we live in a pandemic, this is also a great option for running outside, maybe if it's in a super crowded area or somewhere where you need to be wearing a mask, this is a good option. You can just slip it right up when you see somebody coming. This neck warmer is $48 on Tracksmith's website, so that might be a little bit steep for some people, and understandably so. So if you're not really in the market to buy something like designer or running designer, then you can just use your standard buff that you get like from buff.com or from a race, and I have one of those here as well. The cool thing about buffs is that you can do a lot of different things with them. So actually during the summer I was using this as a headband, and you can also use it as neck protection and as a neck warmer during those cold months. Okay, Okay, so now let's move to the upper body and how I keep myself warm there. The first piece of advice that I give is that you always want the ability to be able to shed layers. One tip that I can give is that when you get ready for a run and you go outside, if you feel cold before you start running, that's actually kind of a good thing because your body temperature is going to rise. You are going to heat up while you're running and you don't want to overheat and be overdressed. The first item of clothing I have is this tank top that I just wear bare, just the tank top in 20 degree weather, and it seems to be just fine. No, I'm just kidding. Really what I use this for is just an extra layer. So if I have this tank top on under a long sleeve, then I might not need a jacket depending on how cold it is because I already have an extra layer. This is just a Dri-Fit tank top from Nike. I've had it for a million years. But if you have like any thin tank top, it does the job just fine. The first long sleeve I have to show you is the Tracksmith Harrier long sleeve. It's great because it's warm, but it does have a tiny bit of breathability. And one really crazy thing about this long sleeve is like, no matter what, it does not smell, which is not the case with a lot of my other running gear. It does get a bit wet, obviously, from your sweat, so you can get a little bit cold. It's definitely on the pricier side. It's $82, and I know a lot of you just, your jaws just dropped, and you're like, are you insane? And yeah, I am kind of insane, so I mean, that makes sense. But also, you're getting such a good quality long sleeve that you're gonna have for years. And then my other favorite long sleeve for winter running is the Nike Dri-Fit long sleeve. I don't really know if that's what it's called, but I think that's what it's called. It's a little bit thicker than the Tracksmith long sleeve. This long sleeve is also a lot better at wicking away sweat. Again, this is Dri-Fit, so it kind of should be. And another great thing is that it has thumb cutouts here. So you can use the sleeves kind of as like little mini gloves. Oh, and this is actually significantly less money than the Tracksmith shirt. It's like $55. So you really can't go wrong. The next thing I recommend for your upper body is a vest. This is a vest by Oiselle, but I loved having this last winter. It was actually like my first winter that I had a running vest. So if you pair this with a long sleeve, and you have lots of protection for your upper body, and then you have your arms kind of more exposed, which is actually nice because then you're definitely not gonna overheat. It's one of those things where I didn't really know I needed it until I had it, and now I kind of can't live without it. And the last and final thing on my list for the upper body in terms of winter running is a jacket. Honestly, I've literally had this jacket since like 2012, so I can't even tell you what it's called. Really, this specific jacket is not the point. Just having a jacket is kind of like what I want to drive home here. I find that the heavier jackets just overheat me no matter what the temperature is outside. But yeah, I love to pair this jacket with a long sleeve under it, and on the very cold days, like I keep saying, put a tank top on under that long sleeve, and I feel perfect, good to go. I don't need a super heavy insulated jacket. This does the job just fine. Okay, so now let's move down to the hands. Spirit fingers. So this might be a little bit strange and a little bit controversial to some people, but I don't always wear the traditional glove on my hand. So what do I mean by that? Well, for days that it's like less cold outside, but you're still gonna need some hand protection, I'll just use your traditional glove. These are Tracksmith gloves. However, I don't personally find gloves super effective. And on extremely cold, painfully cold days, your fingers need to be together. And that is why I just wear socks on my hands. Nope, I'm not kidding. So my dad, he actually was the one who got me into doing this. And yes, I realized that mittens do exist and I should probably just buy a pair. But honestly, I find the sock thing to be really effective. Hello! So if you don't want to spend money on mittens, then don't. Just get a pair of long socks, put them on your hands, and call it a day. I wonder how many trolling comments I'm gonna get about that. Moving down to the legs, I'm basically wearing leggings with the exception of one pair of pants that I really like that we're gonna talk about right now. But I have two pairs of leggings to show you and one pair of other kind of pants. So the first pair of leggings that I have are 2XU running tights. I love 2XU. I was wearing it before Kim Kardashian was wearing it for fashion, which I'm not sure why that was ever a thing. But in terms of running, these are great. They're very stretchy. They're very flexible. There's a pocket in the back back for some nutrition storage, and they keep me generally warm. They are not insulated. There's not really any lining, so they can get a little bit cold, but it's kind of one of those things where once you start running, you don't really feel it anymore. And they also have great Black Friday sales, just as a tip. For colder days where I need a little bit of lining in my leggings, I have Nike Pro leggings. These are, again, lined. They're fuzzy on the inside. And I love these too. They're super comfortable and soft, and they fit really nice. The only issue with this pair of leggings is that there's no pockets. So there's nowhere to store anything if that's what you want to do. You'd have to store it in your jacket or in a spy belt, whatever the case. These are a lot more practical and easy to find if you just want to go to Dick's or Modell's or whatever's around you and pick up a pair of leggings for the winter. And the last pair of pants that I have are the Tracksmith Session Pants. They're the perfect balance between breathable and warm. There is a pocket on the back too, which I love. And they're just really good quality. And again, they kind of have the same thing with the Harrier shirt I talked about earlier, where they don't really smell ever. The only downside to me of these pants is that they are ridiculously expensive. They're $118. They might last a long time, but they still are pretty expensive. And that leads me to my feet. So we're not gonna talk about shoes, we're gonna talk about socks. The first pair are these Balega socks. I actually haven't worn these yet in the winter, but I think these would be the perfect winter sock. They were a little bit warm for me for the summertime, but they're really cozy and padded, which makes them even more comfortable. I'm actually really excited to try these out in the winter and see how they do. I think it's gonna be a pretty positive experience. And my last and final article of clothing and go-to sock is the Stance sock that I have right here. It has a really cool pattern. It has like mountains on it. Anyway, it's really warm and I like it because it comes up a bit higher. So the bottom of your leg is getting a little bit of more insulation there, especially on very cold days. And with that is all of my winter gear. Well, not all of it, but the highlights. I'll do my best to link everything in the description of this video so you can check it out, buy your own. I know the winter is coming, so we gotta start making some moves on this stuff. But anyways, that concludes my video on winter running gear. If you enjoyed this video, please like it down below and subscribe. And when you're done with all that, hit that notifications bell down below so you can find out every time I upload a new video. I have another video for you guys on Sunday, but in the meantime, get out there, get on the grind, and don't forget to run like heller. See you next time.